All right, it's me again. So this is Colon's debunking of Tariq Nasheed's microphone check trailer. It's kind of weird to be debunking a trailer, but I'm just gonna be twice as weird and debunk his debunking of the trailer. 2.0, it's actually more like 3.0, because he had up two different videos trying to debunk the trailer that he took down. I don't know exactly why, but he's changed his arguments in each one of those and left some things out. Probably, you know, maybe he, hopefully he realized he was wrong about some of them, and I'll mention some of those, but I'm right, here we go.
So here's the thing. The question that needs to be asked, is hip-hop really 50 years old? Because if it's 50 years old, that means it began in 1973.
Yeah, that's what everybody just celebrated, the 50th year. You know, I mean, is he trying to get everybody to celebrate it again in 2025? You know, this idea of dates is cool for people to celebrate. It's good to understand the order of way things happen. But when it comes to culture, trying to pinpoint dates for the beginning of a culture doesn't really work. These points in history that we're looking at where someone did something to add on to the culture, there's always someone that's come before them that they're building on. I'm not saying we shouldn't use dates at all, but trying to put a date on the start of a culture is more of a technique to control the narrative than anything else. It's also not going to work. No one's going to go along with this 1975 year or even later.
Which it did not. So the Kool Herc party at 1520 was not a hip hop party. You don't see hip hop until, at least with Kool Herc, until 1975.
All right. So is he saying that Kool Herc is lying about he brought in the merry-go-round technique in 73? I think that's what he's saying, you know. All right, so you kind of have to show some evidence for that, because unless you were there to refute that story, then that's the story we have, all right, let's look at some clips from this Joe Conzo interview. He actually makes some good points, but Colon doesn't like him and tries to steer him back on code, back to the narrative that he's putting out there. All right, let's listen.
How early do you see what came to be known as hip hop, which is New York City street culture?
New York City street culture, the Bronx culture, youth culture. He's keying them in. Don't get off cold, Conzo. Don't mention any kind of precursors. We don't want to go back that far.
New York City street culture. How early do you see this, and what do you see?
Well, I'm 60 years old. Mm-hmm. Born in 1963, okay? So I can remember going to street jams and park jams 8, 9, 10 years old. So, you know, 70, 71, but nobody was calling it hip-hop. Hip-hop didn't come about until later on. Mm. You know, it wasn't until years later, you know, depending on what narrative you want to listen to, you know, this one and the Army Cadence, hip-hop, you know, and, you know, bam, putting it all under one umbrella.
Right.
You know, so, I mean, I don't know if you can't pinpoint a precise date on this culture. You can't. And I challenge anybody to do that.
All right, so he's making a good point about culture. I made the same point. Colon doesn't like that. He's going to steer him back. But it is interesting that he kind of gave out a date of 1970, which is the same date that Kool Herc gave in one of his interviews. He said 1970. Colon doesn't like that. He really wants to push it all the way to 75 and later, to fit as many Puerto Ricans and Jamaicans in as he possibly can. Let's see what he says.
I would never try to pinpoint a date. I would pinpoint a year.
Well, that's pinpointing a date, man.
And I would say that there's reasons behind that. When you look, I definitely know that there definitely are jams. There definitely are outdoor parties. There definitely are block parties happening 70, 71, 72, 73, you know, in the Bronx, in Brooklyn. Yeah, I know that. When we talk about this specific culture, this New York City Bronx subculture that comes about, you don't really start to see the embers of that fire burning based around everything that I've seen, based around everything that I've heard from the pioneers, from people like Flash, from people like Coke La Rock, from people like, you know, Dancing Doug, from people that were there, practitioners.
Stay on cold, Joe Conzo. Stay on cold.
Would say it's not 73. It's more like 75. And I happen to believe that based around what's taking place, that year is pivotal. So that's the year that Flash introduces people to the quick mix theory at 23 Park.
All right. He has a problem with that because if Herc introduces the merry-go-round in 75 instead of 73, then how is it that Flash, seeing that, goes in his house and practices for a year before he brings out the quick mix theory, right? So that's incorrect.
Is the Hevelo and introduces the Herculoid sound system. That's the year Coke La Rock takes rock at the Hevelo. That's the year Herc starts calling the dancers B-boys. That's the year that he comes out with the merry-go-round. It's like,
see, he's incorrect about that. Something doesn't work there. Either Herc brought the merry-go-round in 73, like he says, or how can Flash come up with the quick mix theory in the same year when he says he went and practiced for over a year in his house?
Like, that's the year that the first B-boys, late 74, 75, start hitting the floor with what we know as the three-step, the four-step, the six-step. So it's that year is pivotal. Then there's people who would say, I lean more towards 77.
Stay on cold, Joe Conzo. He might as well just say 77. He might as well say 79. That's when the first records came out. He can go ahead and say 80. That's or 80, 81. That's when hip hop appeared in print for the first time. He can push it all the way as far as he wants to. But that's the problem with trying to pinpoint a date. Yes, a year is a date. That's the problem with trying to pinpoint a date. Because you have a culture that's evolving. It doesn't have a pinpoint date that you can put on there unless it's you with your opinion trying to create a narrative by changing the metrics and changing the scope. Oh, it's only in the Bronx. It only happens when B-boys go down to the floor. It only happens when this thing happens and the other thing happens and this thing happens, which are all your own metrics. So this is just your opinion. It's not a fact. All right. So we can look at it with your theory. The problem is everyone else already chose the 73 day, right or wrong, to celebrate. So it doesn't make any kind of sense to be trying to change, the date. All he's trying to do with that change in date is fit as many Puerto Ricans in before the date. That's it. Nothing else.
Because after the blackout, it seemed like more people got more equipment. Blah, blah, blah. And yeah. I get that. I know people who went to the 73 party with Herc. And, you know, I've asked them, what was happening?
I still haven't met anybody that went to that party.
Dancing Doug was at that party. Coke La Rock was at that party.
Okay. Yeah.
They were at that party. And they said there was a lot of people who said they were at that party that weren't at that party. So, and they described it. But I asked, at least I asked Doug. Obviously, I haven't spoken to Coke La Rock, but I asked Doug. And he said, you know, and there's an interview actually with Dancing Doug and Herc, and they're talking about that party. And Herc says, yeah, you know, anybody that doesn't believe you were there, I'm saying that you were there. Mm-hmm. So, you know, I asked him on the phone one day, what was happening at that party? Was that hip hop? Were they emceeing? Were they b-boying? Were they? He said, no, that's not happening there.
And I don't believe. I don't believe that for one second, man. I do not believe that for one second. This is something that Colon does again and again and again. He takes people's words and he shades them differently. So I don't know what Dancing Doug said on the phone. Colon should actually interview him and try to shade him into this. There was no hip hop in 73 at Herc's party. I don't believe it at all. Let's look at a couple clips from an interview with Dancing Doug and see if that's something he would tell Colon.
So the first clubs that they had was at the Twilight Zone in the Heap. But they started at 1520 Sedgwick in the recreation. So going to parties there, then they go out to the park, and that was like crazy. I tell people, we doing the history of breakdancing and b-boy by a chronological timeline. So in 73, if we're going to say that nationally recognized date as a start is August 11, 73. Even though I was dancing before 73, Trixie was dancing before 73, Sasa, Bobo, Twins, Clark Kent, you know, everybody was dancing before. Well, the Twins were kind of young. They were some kind of young kids. Sydney would let them come in, but they still were cute kids who could dance, you know. So when we had the big circles, you have a big circle for the main circles, Trixie, Wallace D, Kitty Rock, you know. That was a big battle, you know, real big. Then you had like Sasa and Bobo, Twins, James Bond, Bossy the Underdog, you know, all these funny names and stuff. But they had those smaller pockets, Kimmy, Arlene, Aileen, Gracie, Sister Boo, all the small pockets, Chip the Mad Hatter. And then as time went on, you had like Charlie Rock and guys coming there too. So you had Bam would come there, Flash would go to Herc's parties, all of them would go to Herc's parties. And it was a lot more of the dancing too, because there was a thing called burning people, which they still do now. You see the guys when they do their little dance, they jump up there, or they crotch their face and walk or whatever. That came from the burning style, you know? So you can see the evolution of the dance when, say, 75, 76, when TBB comes in, and they were rocking crew. Like, I'd never heard the expression up rock, top rock. I'd never even heard them until I started doing the documentary.
So you guys were inspired by James Brown. You said Lindy Hop, Charleston. Well, whereas people of the day, they got generation after generation of Beatles before.
Yeah.
What are the other things that inspired you besides the ones that I mentioned?
Well, to be perfectly honest, we were like doing something new. So it wasn't like we had something to pattern ourselves out. It was just us dancing against each other and trying to outdo each other every week, trying to make up something new because it was sort of like a new thing now. So it was nothing to say, I like how that works. Like I got an argument with one guy, he says, well, you don't do what you guys do. You know, so we're different from you. And I said, well, let me ask you a question. Did you wake up one morning, you know, 15 years old, walk across your living room, put on It's Just Begun and start spitting on your head? No, saw some spinning from running a circle. I do like a curl, like we still just run in circles like this, spin around. Run in circles to spin in circle, to spin on your back, spin on your head. It's evolution. You didn't just wake up one morning and start doing this. You saw somebody and saw somebody who used this Kool Herc music because it's the music, because there's no real original dance. You can look at videos of people from, you know, 1920s and 1930s doing leg swipes and flares and all this. It's nothing original. It's how we do it to this kind of music, what makes us different in this generation. That's all it is. So don't go, I'm the one who created. Yeah, easy up on that. You know, you really create that. You're doing it. You really create it. So I was like, you can say that, but I'm like, okay, all right. People spun their head before. They did that. But doing it to this kind of music and this kind of way makes it unique. That's why I said, this is our time. It's a B-boy line, chronological line. It starts in 73. We're in 2021 now. It's evolved. It's gotten better and better and better and better. So where are you on that timeline? What did you bring to the dance to make the dance better? That's the question. How do you make the dance better? What did you bring to the dance to say something unique and say, I do this to make this look like that and bump it up. Now, it's bumps. You can see from 73 to 75, first bump, you add the rocking to it, it bumps up. You hit a gymnast, the first time you hit somebody doing gymnastics, 76, it bumps up again. And then you see it just bump, and it's bumping high. Well, I'm doing elbows, and I'm gonna do this, I'm gonna do this, I'm gonna do what? Bumps, it bumps, it bumps. So now the dance goes like this. Line still goes like that, chronologically. Dance evolution. I'm philosophical now.
All right, so I highly doubt that Dancing Doug told Colon that there was no hip hop in 1973 at Herc's parties. Yeah, it's worth checking out this whole interview. I'm gonna leave the link in the comments.
But I started thinking to myself, I said, if I was just to put just us, there'll still be debates about people think, well, I heard Rocksteady started breakdance. Well, I heard the Zulu Nation started breakdance. And I'm going like, I can show you Rocksteady came from TBB. I can say with Zulu Nation, but even TBB got permission from Zulu. I can show you for interviews, but from Batch, Nabby, you know, them going to Zulu Masters and them say, well, Beaver was the first real Beaver. But I can show you Beaver was Baby Shaka, was one of the kings, masters, Swerpy, who was named Shaka, has got Shaka, Ahmed, Kusa, those guys. 5 Zulu masters and 10 Zulu kings. I can show you Beaver was a baby Zulu. He was Baby Shaka. So he was getting his influence from someone else. And then he split a Herc. So I can show that timeline. So I think it's good to show that timeline and watch it evolve. So the documentary, I said, let me just show the evolution of it, not just through just the old generation, but then from us to Zulu Nation, TBB, to Rocksteady, to Dynamic Rockers, to then you got the big crew, you got the Floor Bastards, the incredible New York City Breakers, Seven Deadly Sin, all the crews. But you can see, boom, 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 the movie hit, the street, breaking hit. Now everybody sees like, what the hell are y'all doing this stuff? Oh, I want to do that all over the world all of a sudden.
When did it start? I'm hearing all these debates that so-and-so's the first B-boy. Did he just wake up one day and say, I'm going to become a B-boy? He had to be influenced by somebody. And then that somebody that influenced him had to be influenced by somebody else. He had to be influenced by somebody.
Somebody.
And then that somebody that influenced him had to be influenced by somebody else.
Somebody else.
And then that somebody that influenced him had to be influenced by somebody else.
Somebody else.
By somebody else.
Somebody else.
By somebody else.
Somebody else. Somebody else. Somebody else. But it had to be influenced by somebody. It's always somebody. It's always somebody. It's going back to somebody. Just somebody. 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 Yeah, somebody.
We don't need no backstabbing. Got a game of stuff. Take care of all my good stuff. Oh! You know I'm gone. I got a bag of my own. Oh! Oh! Oh my good wood. I don't back up. Take my teeth. My baby cup. My you know.